You're clear.
Because we're talking probably 50, 60 mile an hour at best. What's going on, guys? We are back with another video, and today
we're doing something a little bit different. Today we've got two ranger buddies, and we're gonna be overlanding for a couple days with them, hitting some trails, going to some really epic campsites, and just having a great time.
Yep, down here in Moab. So the Blue Ranger is Spencer, and then the Orange Ranger behind him is Meta. So we're gonna, again, as she said, we're gonna have some really awesome and epic moments, so make sure to stay tuned.
We started our Moab adventure by taking one of the more popular routes, Gemini Bridges. Now this trail has some beautiful views and some fun obstacles along the way to keep things interesting.
Picked a different line, just like that, nice and steady, keep the momentum, and we're good. A spicy rock structure. Nothing too crazy. In two-wheel drive. There you go. He's fine. There you go. Yeah, buddy. A little bit of a different approach, different line. All work just as good. Yeah. Oh.
All right, so we just pulled up into camp. This was camp for tonight. Pretty cool spot. Got the red Moab rock behind us with a bunch of big boulders. Got the tent set up. Meta is currently setting up his tent, and Spencer and his GFC topper all opened up. And we got a nice sunset going on back there. Gonna get dinner going. And then just sitting by the fire, relaxing, enjoying the night. And we'll catch you guys in the morning.
After we finished our breakfast, we packed up camp and headed out for our day two adventures. We had a lot of ground to cover, as we had about 50 to 60 miles of trails planned for today to get to our next spot. Our route started by going through one of the back entrances of Arches National Park. Now this back entrance is a great way to see Arches National Park during its peak season, where reservations are required. Obviously through this entrance, reservations are not required. We ended up taking a side road called Tower Arch 4x4 Trail, in which you'll see it's a pretty fun and technical trail with a lot of cool arches along the way.
We'll see how she does. Not too much drama. There you go. Nice. Line he takes. That's why we got skid plates. So we've come across our next obstacle, which is kind of a stairwell of off-camber goodness. That's slippery rock. Put on that locker, propel you forward. Nice and easy, a little bit of drama. And just keep her pushing up those stairs. And just like that, she's up.
Come forward.
Fighting the mosquitoes while on the trail. Nice and easy. No drama, no nothing. Alright, so we now have come across some slick downhill. So we've put the truck into sports mode, downshifted it into first gear to do some engine braking, and then just slow and steady is gonna win that race. And we'll just watch that rear. Mm-hmm. Now we've got Spencer. Took a little bit of a different line. Perfect. That back is coming down. Good job. So I did not want him to basically straddle this. As you can see, it's a pretty deep divot. And as he moved forward, he definitely did leave a little thing down. You don't want to get caught up on your diff or on anything for that matter and get high centered. So opted for a better line. Go a little bit more passenger, straighten out, and you're good there. Yeah. You're welcome. Now you can start cutting a little bit towards me. Okay. Okay. Nice. Opted for a little bit different, to go a little bit wider and then cut sooner. So it's more of a straight approach instead of having a turn while on that. And just like that, all down. All right, so we've reached our next kind of big old rock obstacle, which I'm sure on camera doesn't look like much. So there is a couple of lines you can take. You can take the hard route. Diagonal this way is going to be your easiest route. Mandy has opted to take the first big old hill and then take the easier hill down so we don't destroy the rear. And we'll see what other lines people choose to take. So let's go. Have him start turning. Yeah. Sends her. Yikes. Nope. Try backing up a little and just doing a little, like a little bump to get that front tire over. I don't know. Yeah.
Going for a low? What's that? Going for a low if you're not. Going for a low back up?
Yeah, buddy.
Straight ahead, I can't see anything.
Keep going. Start turning, driver.
Bottom out your...
We ended up making a quick pit stop to check out these fossilized dinosaur footprints off of Willow Springs Road. Something really cool to see out in nature and not in a museum.
All right, so we have reached our second trail of the day. And we've reached kind of the first questionable, if you will, obstacle. So we are taking this side and hoping not to hit that rear. Slow and steady. And there's that hitch. Alright, so we've come across another pretty big step up. Gonna give it a go. Make sure we clear it and we don't just nail the bumper. Get those tires up and up and over. Probably gonna smack the rear. Two-wheel drive, probably gonna give it another bump. There you go. Short, sweet, and simple. Ooh, those rock sliders, it's technically what they're there for. Line.
After this last obstacle, we had no idea how beautiful this trail was about to get.
Chicken Corners Trail here
in Moab, Utah, and it's absolutely gorgeous. The boys are pulling up right now, just pulled in. They're pulling up, and it's awesome. You should definitely come out here. It's not a difficult trail by any means. I did the whole thing just now in two-wheel drive, so totally doable. Alrighty guys, we just pulled up here into camp, and as you can see behind us, we got a little triangle formation going on, and this campsite is a real treat. Got cliffside view of the Colorado River with that red rock all surrounding it. It's a gorgeous campsite. So came in a little later than expected, so we got a lot of unpacking, cooking, and kind of doing all the catching up things that we need to do to set up camp. So probably catch you guys in the morning. All right, I have no idea if you guys can see, but we are currently being sandblasted.
Crazy.
And we're trying to kind of panic here, and their tent is getting torn up, and our tent is currently taking a beating right now, and we're being sandblasted, so we'll keep you guys posted on if we survive this and if all our gear survives this, because we're talking probably 50-60 mile an hour gusts right now. So we're currently sitting in the truck. I don't know if you can see the dust that is blowing across my headlights and my ditch lights, but the truck is literally rocking from the wind. We've got everything packed up and buttoned away. We are currently gonna try to move to our secondary backup spot, and hopefully at that location it is not that windy and we're kind of sheltered away from this ridiculous wind.
Wipe the back track to get out, because there's not another campsite on here.
Yeah, it's probably an hour down the trail in this darkness. It is right now about 10 o'clock at night, so we'll let you know how it goes. So we're all packed away, everybody packed away, and Meta, the one in the orange truck, we have misplaced keys. So in order to try to escape the wind, we're now playing essentially a giant group of scavenger hunt to find the keys as we feel raindrops pulling in. So things just got a lot more interesting. So we'll see how it goes. All right, so good news. We ended up finding the keys after the very long manhunt. I want to say it was at least an hour of tearing apart everything. We ended up finding them. Rolled up in the door on that tent rolled up, and it was tied up. It was inside of that, I guess, with the wind and stuff, and frantically trying to close the tent, it somehow ended up in there. We found the keys. It has significantly, the wind has decreased, so we might just end up camping here the night now that the wind's died down after the hour-long manhunt. But we're definitely tired, because I think it's close to midnight at this point. So see you guys in the morning and figure out where we'll end up camping.
We ended up camping there for the night, as the wind never picked back up, so we were able to enjoy some beautiful views as we woke up in the morning. This was an in and out trail, so on the way out we obviously had to backtrack everything we did yesterday. If you've made it this far in the video, make sure to leave a like on the video, and if you aren't subscribed, make sure to hit that subscribe button. It's free, helps the channel out a bunch, and a lot of time and effort goes into these videos that people don't realize, so make sure you hit the subscribe button to catch more videos like this. So on our way back from Chicken Corners, we came across this Jeep that was coming up a different trail, much more difficult trail, and on the last
last obstacle, he snapped his U-joint. So currently in the process of backing up the truck to use the truck as an anchor point because he does have a winch. So we'll see how this goes.
All right, so we are currently backing up just a little bit more to attach. So we have a, oh snap. Yeah, you're good. All right, so before I almost fell, we are just backing up slightly, connecting to his winch. There's the GPS down there. So currently going to, he's gonna get in. We're gonna use the truck as an anchor because it is a little bit too much of drama to actually just pull him. And then we will just essentially get him over that obstacle that he is currently hung up on because he cannot get over that in two-wheel drive, and then should get him back on the main road and we should all be on our way. He's using that winch. You can literally see it flapping. So next route of action, we've gotten him over the obstacle he was hung up on, so we are going to see what he can do on his own power. He pulled out his drive shaft that was stuck. I mean, that's one way to get her done.
Give it the beam. So close.
Fun sometimes leads to breaking more unnecessary things. Have reached our second trail for today, and we've kind of come across this first obstacle, which is quite interesting. It's a pretty steep and slippery uphill kind of steps. We've got a little wheel lift. But hey, it's part of wheeling. All right, So here we have Spencer. We're going to take a little bit of a different line. We're going to take the higher ground since we've got less clearance. This is just the beginning. There's stuff that's like, it's like coming up like this. This trail gets real interesting real quick.
That's why I get out here and remember to get out. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Hit. You gotta listen to me. Focus. You can't just full send it. Are you in far low? Okay. You gotta listen to me. You gotta come on, go back up. Back up.
He's hitting those steps.
Mm-hmm. Go, driver. No, the other way.
Nice little steep uphill with some off camber. uncomfortable angles.
So this is the most difficult obstacle along this trail. I would rate this obstacle at about a 6. Obviously, video never does it justice, but it is a pretty big obstacle.
You're gonna drop a little bit, turn a little more driver. All right, keep coming down. Start cutting in. Keep cutting, straighten out. All right, now turn, driver. Your tire's where you wanted it. Slowly drop. Passenger's dropping. You're gonna wanna probably come more passenger. Now, probably start cutting. I don't know about that. I can't see the other side. Okay. There you go. Nice and slow. Okay, watch that back. You're clear. Woo! Sketchy. So we have Spencer taking a little bit of a different line. He is he's on, I believe, 31s. I might be wrong, 31s or 32s. So we don't think that he's actually gonna clear this, and he's also on stock suspension. So we're having him take a little bit of a different line. So he's going to make a hard S at the top of the trail, kind of parallel along here, and then come down a more mild section. So we have Meta up next. He has opted to take the same line that Mandy just took. So he's gonna be coming straight up, down, and down.
ready to drop. There you go. Clear. Woo! So we've come across another kind of interesting section. So it's a couple of just like off camber kind of sections, and then you have a rock that you kind of have to climb at the front end. So we checked, we do have the clearance for it, and he's gonna give her a go. Nice and simple, short, sweet, and simple. All right, so here we have Spencer opting for a little bit of a different line. But the top, there's quite the gnarly rock. Changing from four high to four low, because we were on. Yes, I am advising. So we had just come on some sugar sand road, so we put it up into four high, changing it to four low, have a little bit more power low end and lower gear. And woo! Just like that. I know that rock probably doesn't look like anything, it's pretty gnarly. Now we have Meta going on Route A, we'll call it. Nice little off camber situations. Nice.
I don't know how the audio is going to be here, but one of the amazing views along this Dome Plateau Trail is that you can literally walk just a couple hundred feet and you're underneath it.
All right, so we've come up on another obstacle on this trail, and as you can see, Armando is 6'5", and that's basically a straight up and down ledge. So, because none of us can actually go down this obstacle in reality, we're going to send Spencer up first to see if his bumper can clear, and then once we determine that, then we'll send the other two brakes that are lifted and with bigger tires. So 100% achievable, just gotta see if we have the clearance. steady wins that race. Make sure we don't plow in with the bumper. Then you just basically feather that throttle. Nice and easy throttle control. Just like that. You're up.
So pit stop number two, that's very scenic after the arches and a little obstacles that we did, is the wind tunnels. They go, that one, they're at the, you see them up there, they're all the way up there at the top of that one. And that one goes in about 200 to 300 feet, so it's definitely a cool thing to stop and see in the on the Dome Plateau Trail. Due to time, we're probably not gonna be able to do the whole thing, just because it is starting to get late and we do need to make it to our campsite tonight. So you're not going to want to miss out on that campsite. It's a pretty epic one.
Here's the entrance of that cave on the right hand side. And it's goes back about 150-200 feet. It's pretty cool. The temperature change in here is pretty crazy.
All right, so we have reached a section of the trail that has gotten extremely spicy. And as you can tell from previous times, people have filled it in. So we filled it in a little bit more. All right, start cutting. Come towards me. Come towards me. Keep the wheel just like that. Okay, keep it just like that. Turn a little bit, driver. All right, come. Turn a little bit, passenger. Keep it just like that. Keep her coming. Keep her coming. Keep her coming. Just like that. Nice and easy. Back is dropping. Perfect. Woo! That was a doozy. So, here comes Spencer. We're gonna take him on the same line.
Yeah. Don't turn too hard yet. So I want those trailing tires across. Right, now hard passenger.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now the top.
Yeah, it's about to drop. Alright. Straighten your tire. Yeah, right there.
Okay.
Straight like that. Nice and slow.
Oh. Yeah.
That's right.
No, it's the rock. He picked up a rock.
Oh, yeah.
He's fine. I don't know about the bottom.
Hold on.
I'm not sure.
Okay, yeah, you're good. Go a little more passenger when you slide. It's just your skid plate. Yeah, you're good. Yep, keep going. It's just the frame.
About to drop. About to drop, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Back's coming down. Yeah, so you have a rock stuck.
It's tension between your exhaust.
Slowly, yeah. I don't know if y'all can see that.
Can you see?
No, it's like wedged in there.
Can you go back?
Hold on, wait. Yeah. Okay.
Tiny bit. No damage. Okay.
Bingo. Hold on. Don't move.
I don't think you're going to be able to hold that.
Yeah.
I think, okay, just slowly creep forward. Don't put your hand there because if it catches, your hand's getting smushed.
Don't
join me.
Just go very slowly forward. Very slow. Yeah.
All right, we're good. Okay.
You're good. You're clear.
So just ease it on down. All tires are down. No drama. Woo! All right, and now we have Meta coming down.
Yep, just like that. Just like that, straight. Uh-huh. You're gonna drop, yep. We're going just like that, just slow on the brakes. Yep.
That was that rock? Yeah.
Just like that, slow on the brakes. Going, passenger's about to drop, in the back. Good. Driver's
butt
drop. There you go.
Nice and steady. Whoop, whoop.
After a long day of hitting trails, we pulled up to our campsite for the night. Being the last night of the trip, we had to make sure we pulled up to a beautiful campsite for the night. Unpacked, set up camp, ate dinner, and sat by the fire until it was time for bed.
So we've come up on our first obstacle, pretty much leaving camp. So we are headed out from a beautiful campsite. Got a nice big rock structure with a decent amount of off camber. So nothing too crazy. So just for reference, he does not have a rear locker, so it's definitely all about finding those right lines and making sure that all four wheels stay balanced. And we're not sending all the power to the wheel with the least resistance. First obstacle conquered.
As we finished this last obstacle, reality set in when we started airing up and saying our goodbyes as we split ways and headed home to end this amazing adventure. If you liked the video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more off-road and overlanding adventures, and we'll catch you guys in the next video.